aside from sort of the honesty, do you think writing this has helped develop like other parts of yourself?
I'm a slightly quicker typer.
Okay. The muscles and the fingers.
It's difficult to. That's a horribly good question. I don't know. I think that the stuff about working on having a respectful marriage and working on your own emotions and being aware of what you're doing, what you're saying, and being more present as a husband and a father, I think that is a work in progress. But I think organising those thoughts towards the end of the book definitely helped. And I think that my feelings about my parents who've died, I think, you know, just the act of structuring that book, I'm sure has helped. I'm always slightly shy of admitting that, really, because I don't want to give the reader the impression that the whole thing is an exercise in me therapizing myself, because that leaves them feeling slightly excluded. But it's a byproduct. You know, it's an outward facing book. I'm there to communicate with the reader. But I think as a bonus, I think it has helped me.
Yeah, good. If someone was to write their own memoir or just their own book in general, what advice would you give them?
The thing about honesty is probably a good start, because you I think it just makes you a better writer. I think if you end up slightly, if you end up being invasive or euphemistic or dodging certain things, then it will just lead to bad writing. That's my experience anyway. I mean, obviously you have to be careful about other people's feelings. I mean, the living people in the book that you're writing about, it's not just your story, because your life overlaps with all these other people. So you know, I would say aim for generosity. Try to write a generous book, and the reader will reward that.
Okay. Obviously you're well known for your comedy. Now, did you mention earlier that you were hoping for some supportive emails would be nice.
Yeah.
But did anyone who knew you were writing this perhaps maybe discourage you because they feel like it's a bit dissimilar from the comedy? Mm. At least some parts of the book are their amusing.
Yeah, no, not really. I mean, obviously when you're dealing with people dying in the book, then there's a certain decorum to be observed there, and you know, that's where the gags dry up a bit, and I think the reader would find it weird if they didn't. So managing those gear changes was a sort of enjoyable challenge. I didn't feel. Actually, I tell a lie. My agent, when I did the initial proposal, I wrote the first two chapters, and he read it and he said, make it 50% funnier. That was the document that was trying to get publishers interested.
Oh, okay.
And that was, I think it's like, because it's my ace card, temptation to underplay it, and just at that particular moment, I even said, take this out for a spin. You know, you need to remind them.
So you didn't feel at all when you were writing it that you thought, people know me for comedy, how funny should I really make this? Or were you just set on doing, how you planned it from the beginning, really?
Yeah, the second bit. I wrote it in the way that felt most natural. And I'm still, you know, I think 80% of it is entertaining. You know, that is still my sort of default way of communicating, is through jokes. But every now and again, I give myself permission not to be funny. But that is still what, you know, professionally speaking, gets me out of bed in the morning. So I do want to entertain people.
Speaking of comedy, do you have perhaps a favourite comedian or comedians that you could name? Or just perhaps ones that have inspired you?
The ones that have inspired me are on much easier territory. The ones that have inspired me in the past, because I'm not watching as much TV as I used to. But, my word, people like Rick Mayall and Hugh Laurie, and Stephen Fryer and Atkinson, Francis Saunders, all that sort of 80s lot. Victoria Wood, my goodness, really, really wonderful people, and some of those old school comics as well. Les Dawson, obviously you wouldn't do that kind of material about mothers-in-law's compound, plural, isn't it, these days, but just his delivery and the way he would play that piano very badly, and you know, I love some of that stuff, but those were the main.
But hard to pick an actual favourite or favourites.
It's somewhere in between Rick Mayall and Hugh Laurie.
Okay. And then, going from favourite comedian, what about books? What about the greatest book you've ever read? Or, again, books you perhaps recommend to people?
I would always recommend Waterman by Graham Swift, which is a really important book for me for reasons I've never really understood. But I sort of love the way he loops around in time, and he talks, and the narrator is a history teacher, and he talks about got from that novel. It's just an amazing book, and there are moments in How Not to Be a Boy where I slightly mimic that looping around thing, and how I'm putting distant events next to each other, and he does that pretty so brilliantly in that book. So if I had to pick one, I'd say that.
I'll put it on the list to read.
Cool, yeah, do.
There's obviously, you know, there's lots of words, lots of sentences, etc. in your book. Is there a particularly sort of important line or a memorable line that sticks out to you?
When I heard it was reported to me that Bob Edwards, the deputy headmaster, had said about me when my mother just died, he needs to be a friend to himself. And I think that that made a big difference to how I addressed that that time. And also it's part of the message that I'm sort of trying to give to my fellow blokes, which is that, you know, we're not gonna do very well at this whole seeing women as fully human and fully equal unless we learn to look after ourselves.
Okay.
Because if you expect them to look after you, then you are immediately, then that is immediately an unequal relationship. So if anything, I'd say it'll be what he said rather than anything I've written.
Okay. So the memorable line that essentially ties into my next question, which would be, if you could give a message to people regarding the whole topic, it would be that then.
Yeah, I guess so. And, you know, try not to be a dick.
Yeah, try not to be a dick to all people.
Yeah.
Well, thank you very much.
Thank you, Gabriel. That was good fun.